We've heard it all before. Vote for us and we'll cut your power bills. Today it was the LNP promising to reduce the cost of electricity by hundreds of dollars. Labor says Tim Nicholls tried and failed to do that in the previous LNP government.
In election campaigns, politicians like to be seen with real people.
Oh, okay, so you've just had a morning nap, have you?
The Pierce family at Glasshouse Mountains listened politely as Tim Nicholls told them they could save $216 next year under his power plan.
You could use that for all sorts of good things.
That's right.
Especially with Christmas coming up.
The LNP would split the two state-owned generating companies into three, unscrambling Labor's 2011 merger. Energy Queensland's assets would be written down by $2 billion to reduce network costs, and federal and state renewable subsidies and targets would go.
An average family on an average power bill will be able to save up to $160 from next year.
From mid-2020, the LNP claims households could save $460 a year, $52 from the generator restructure, $108 from the asset write-down, $115 after the end of the federal renewable subsidy scheme, and $200 from scrapping state Labor's 50% renewable target. Power price promises sound great. The trouble is, does anyone believe them? Voters have heard it all before from both sides. The LNP had a plan in 2011-12.
Average households using around 6 megawatt hours per year could save around $120.
He promised when he was going for office that he would reduce household bills. Not only did he raise household bills by 43%, he had a plan to sell the power assets in this state.
Mr. Nicholls insists that plan doesn't exist anymore. Not that the ETU will let him forget it. Even at the Pierce's place, one of them tracked him down.
Welcome to Glasshouse, Tim.
One Nation has its eye on Glasshouse. Senator Hanson enters the fray tomorrow on the One Nation campaign bus.
Big deal. Pauline Hanson isn't running here in Queensland. Steve Dixon is.
But the question of LNP One Nation preferences is running and still hasn't been answered. Chris O'Brien, ABC News.